Bam! Mr. Drew, in this video, we're going to be taking a look at number 5 from the 2018 AP Calculus BC test. In the description, you'll find links to the timestamps that go to each of the three parts of this question. You'll also find links to the APCentral website where you can download this PDF, the marking scheme, the scoring comments from the master graders so you can see where students earned and did not earn their points. Here we have the graphs of the polar curves, r is equal to 4, so the equation of a circle centered around the pole, and r is equal to 3 plus 2 cosine of theta, a lemmasan, are shown. The curves intersect at theta is equal to pi over 3, and theta is equal to 5 pi over 3. Now in part A it says here, let r be the shaded region, bam, right there in green. That is inside the graphs of r is equal to 4 and outside the graph of r is equal to 3 plus 2 cosine of theta. So maybe it sounds like they don't want you to miss this calculus question because you're not sure which of these graphs is, I don't know, maybe what they look like. Kind of unnecessary, I believe, there. Write an expression involving an integral for the area of r. So we don't need to solve it because it would actually be quite difficult to integrate, but just simply write out the expression. So our area, well, let's remember that the area within a polar curve is equal to 1/2 the definite integral from alpha to beta of r squared d theta. And let me just double check that, yeah. Now, this is going to be true if the difference between beta and alpha is somewhere between the measurements of 0 and 2 pi radians. Okay, well, here we're finding the area of a shaded region, so we want to find the area, sort of the large region, and take out the area of that smaller one. So we're going to find the area within the lemmasan between, the circle, between pi over 3 and 5 pi over 3, and then that's going to be kind of like, sort of like you've taken a pizza and cut out a couple of pieces of it. And then we're going to take out the area of the lemmasan and just simply, you know, that's it. So we're going to have that our area is equal to 1/2 the definite integral from pi over 3 to 5 pi over 3. And then we're going to take out that area again from this large region, which is going to be that circle r is equal to 4. So r, which is going to be 4 squared minus, and that's going to be, like I said, this region sweeping from here down to 5 pi over 3. Now we're going to take out this area of the lemmasan between those two angle measures, which is going to be the 3 plus 2 cosine of theta squared d theta. And that is it. Part A is done. Part B coming up right now. So for part B, we want to find the slope of the line tangent to the graph of r is equal to 3 plus 2 cosine of theta at theta is equal to pi over 2. So we want to find the slope, well, of this polar curve. Now, let's not forget that slope is a change, you know, of change of vertical direction over a change of a horizontal direction, a dy over dx. No mention of theta or taking a derivative with respect to theta in this notation. So what we need to do is we need to take the derivative of y with respect to theta and a derivative of x with respect to theta, and then we're going to divide those, and basically that's going to allow those d thetas to cancel out, giving us the derivative expression we want, so we can analyze it at theta is equal to pi over 2. Now our derivative is still going to be in terms of theta, even though we don't see that theta notation into the derivative notation. How are we going to get an equation for y and an equation of x out of r is equal to 3 plus 2 cosine of theta? Well, we're going to remember that y over r is equal to the cosine, but sine of theta. What the heck am I doing? So then we have that y is equal to r sine of theta. Y, therefore, is equal to r, which is 3 plus 2 cosine of theta times sine of theta. So y is equal to 3 sine of theta plus 2 sine of theta cosine theta. And we can go ahead and, if you'd like, write that as a double angle identity so we don't have to use the product rule as we take a derivative. And we have that y is equal to 3 sine of theta plus sine of 2 theta, and then dy d theta is equal to, taking a derivative now, the derivative of sine is cosine, and the derivative of sine is cosine, but that we have that inside function of 2 theta, and the derivative of 2 theta with respect to theta is just going to be 2. So we have dy d theta is equal to 3 cosine of theta plus 2 cosine of 2 theta. And I don't have a whole classroom of students watching me do my work to tell me if I've made a silly mistake, so let me double check. We are good. Okay, now with that same process, we're going to find an expression or an equation that is x in terms of theta so that we then can take its derivative and then ultimately get our nice cleaned up version of dy over dx. So we need to get this to be x equals, well, we have x over r is equal to the cosine of theta. I'm kind of just recalling those conversion formulas that you learned back in pre-calc to convert between polar and rectangular coordinate system, not just try and give you some kind of magic formula to find the derivative of this function. As I look in my textbook, they give you this, it appears to be just this, like, I mean, you can kind of see where it comes from, but this complicated formula to memorize for the derivative of a polar curve. But yeah, you don't need to worry about that. Just remember that you need an equation for x and an equation for y. So x is equal to r cosine theta. X is equal to 3 plus 2 cosine of theta. Now times cosine of theta. Distribute that together. And we have x equals 3 cosine of theta plus 2 cosine squared of theta. Now we're going to find that dx d theta. Take the derivative of x with respect to theta. And the derivative of cosine is negative sine, so negative 3 sine of theta. And here we have the cosine of theta inside the power of 2, so we're going to bring that power down and reduce, so plus 4 cosine of theta. Now inside that power of 2 we have the cosine function, so we have to finish that chain rule. The derivative of cosine is negative sine, so we're going to change this plus 4 to minus sine theta. Once again, we can, I guess really not necessary here because we've already taken the derivative rule and I'm not trying to avoid that use of the product rule, but if you choose to, this can be written as negative 3 sine of theta minus 2 times 2 sine theta cosine theta. And dx d theta is equal to negative 3 sine of theta minus 2 sine of 2 theta. One more time, just double check. Make sure you don't carry on with a small silly mistake. Excellent. So we got all that done. We're going to go ahead and get this out of the way. Write our derivative notation indicating that we do want to take that derivative at theta is equal to pi over 2. This is for teaching purposes. Maybe you could just go ahead and plug in the pi over 2 as you go to write your work. Is that exam is timed. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and write that derivative notation there. So go ahead and plug in the no need to rush it. That is 3 cosine pi over 2 plus 3 cosine 2 times pi over 2. I'm going to 3 cosine pi over 2 plus 2 times 2 pi over 2. Now notice I'm not going to put an equal sign here. I'm not going to open up a bunch of doors for the AP to be able to mark off and stop grading because there's a linking error somewhere, like you just write something wrong and then rewrite it correctly on the next line. No need to lose those points. The cosine of pi over 2 is equal to 0 plus 2 The cosine of 2s are going to cancel out here, of course. The cosine of pi is negative 1. Down here, we have the sine of pi over 2, which is equal to 1. So negative 3. And copy error. There we go. The sine of pi is equal to 0. So our final answer here is that the derivative of y, or dy dx, the slope of the line tangent to the graph, r is equal to 3 plus 2 cosine of theta at pi over 2 is equal to 2/3. And again, just make sure you give those AP graders a statement in context of the problem for every single problem. Don't say the slope is 2/3. The slope of this limaison is not 2/3 at every angle measure. It is specifically at theta is equal to pi over 2. You could also write a sentence, you know, the slope of this curve at theta equals pi over 2 is 2/3. Part 3 coming up right now. No. Alrighty. So for part C of number 5, we have a question here that says a particle moves along the portion of the curve r is equal to 3 plus 2 cosine theta for theta being between 0 and pi over 2. The particle moves in such a way that the distance between the particle and the origin increases at a constant rate of 3 units per second. Find the rate at which the angle theta changes with respect to time at the instant theta is equal to pi over 3. Okay, now, I'll be honest. First time I tried to do this question, I didn't read it quite slow enough, and I was like, oh, okay, so they just said that the distance between the particle and the origin increases a constant rate of 3 units per second, and I'm like, okay, well, here's a radius, and here's a radius, and here's a radius, and here's a radius, and I'm thinking about, you know, how you graph a polar graph using a t-table, and I'm just automatically thinking that theta is going to go between 0 and pi over 2, so those radii are going to be shrinking. And it threw me off a little bit when it said that the distance between the particle and the origin increases at a constant rate of 3 units per second. So I started to doubt myself because I thought, well, wait a minute, these radiuses are not getting bigger, they're getting smaller. But stating that this is the domain does not indicate that we have to be going from theta equals 0 to theta is equal to pi over 2. There's no kind of like indicated direction that in the way that this particle is moving. And you'll see that when we get to the final answer. Another thing to be careful about when you do this question, or questions similar to this, some of you may have done this in the past, but if we take this test, if we're studying for it coming up, is pay attention to those units of measure. Find the rate of at which angle theta changes with respect to time, not respect to theta. That's going to really throw off your work as well if you rush into this and you're like, oh, I'm just going to take a derivative of the polar equation, and oh, the independent variable is theta, so I'll just take the derivative with respect to theta, because then you're going to have a problem here. Read this one more time. Basically, the radius is changing by 3 units, not per theta, but per second, or a measurement of time. So time is actually measured in seconds. So you have a unit of measure here to pay attention to as you do your final work. So we have that r is equal to 3 plus 2 cosine theta. We're going to take the derivative of this equation in polar form, and not, again, with respect to theta, but with respect to time. So we have a left-hand side, dr dt. On the right-hand side, the derivative of a constant, no matter what you're taking the derivative with respect to, of course, is 0. The derivative of cosine is negative sine. So we have negative 2 sine of theta. And that's not our final answer, of course, because, we're not taking a derivative with respect to theta. So we have to finish up here with a d theta dt. So now that we have our sort of actually a simple related rate problem, if you will, dr dt, well, that distance between the particle, which is, you know, the path of that being described by this limaison, and the distance between that and the origin, basically your dr dt, is that 3 units per second. So this is going to be 3 Now we have negative 2 sine of, okay, what other information did they give us? They told us that theta is equal to pi over 3. So the sine of pi over 3 d theta dt. So we have 3 divided by negative 2 times the sine of pi over 3, which is square root of 3 over 2, which is then equal to, with the 2's canceling out, negative 3 over the square root of 3. AP would be perfectly happy with that, I'm sure, because you don't get points for simplification, you get points for the calculus. I'm going to go ahead and do this and say that we have negative 3 square root of 3 over 3, or we have negative square root of 3, which is equal to, that is what d theta dt is equal to. Now, am I done? Whether they say it or not, and I did not write it, but whether they say it or not, this particular problem did, you always want to use that correct units of measure when units of measure are given to you in the problem, or write, you know, some kind of statement in the context of the problem. It said, did say use the correct units of measure. So d theta dt is negative square root of 3 radians per second when, it's not constant, it's when specifically theta is equal to pi over 3. Let's make sure I didn't say anything silly or do something. Nope, that's it. That is number 5. I'm as true. Bam! Go to your homework.